The Rolling Academy is a 12-day expedition that uses a bus as a classroom, a home base, and a means for transportation. The Rolling Academy strives to develop leaders through expeditionary learning by providing chances for students to discover and grow through new experiences and unique opportunities. The Rolling Academy has its foundation built on 6 guiding principles: craftsmanship, communication, community, environmental awareness, leadership, and service. The goals of the Rolling Academy activities are to make students aware of their leadership capabilities and to inspire them to make changes in their communities based on their growth and development. Stepping into thin air off an almost 200-foot cliff is not something most people are comfortable with. As human beings, we fear the unknown, and rappelling was an unknown experience for all of us. Before we got to the edge of the cliff, we stressed the importance of stretching our comfort zones in order to make us more effective leaders. But I really don't think any of us were expecting to be stretching it to such an extreme, especially not on the first day of our expedition. Some of us are more terrified than others, but we got through it together, every single one of us. Once we had all made it to the bottom, you could see the pride on everyone's faces from having conquered such a fear. This left us excited and anticipating the experiences to come.
Next up was New Jersey. In New Jersey, we met Teresa, Brian, Tony, Bill, and Caroline. After time exploring the beach, we began an activity that required patience, passion, and precision. Quilting. I was completely outside my comfort zone, and I saw looks of frustration from many of my fellow trip members. We spent the rest of the night bonding with the family, and in the morning we enjoyed a slamming breakfast. I will never forget our last day in New Jersey. We rowed. Most went into the crew boat expecting a walk in the park and left feeling challenged. With a couple of sad goodbyes, we left the home in New Jersey, an experience that we'll never forget.
When they told us we were going to the Outdoor Nation Summit today, I kind of figured it would be, well, easy. Was I ever wrong? Arriving at Outdoor Nation, we were greeted by about 100 other adult and youth that all definitely had one thing in common: the great love of the outdoors.
After meeting a few new people, Ivan, the director of Outdoor Nations, introduced us to our true purpose there: to brainstorm ways to get youth outdoors.
Several hours of hard work and collaboration, a beautiful sunset meeting on top of a fort, and a late night speech writing session later, our idea was ready to present. So we came, we saw, and we most certainly conquered, winning a $750 grant for our new initiative, Spreading Roots, which will be kicking off this year.
We left the Outdoor Nation Summit in Boston and headed further north. We ended up in the Maine Maritime Academy and met up with Hugh Horner. After breakfast, we headed down to the docks where we boarded Ned, a navigation vessel. Captain Hannah showed us how to navigate ships using compasses, charts, and high-tech computers. When we got back onto the mainland, we immediately got into a launch that took us to the Bowdoin. The Bowdoin is a National Historic Landmark sailboat that is 91 years old. While on board, we were made new crew members, and we were given the task to raising sails, keeping bow watch, and even steering the ship. Some of us got to tag along on the official boat checks, which allowed us to see the more technical side of sailing. The crew also taught some of the history of the 88-foot sailboat. We also learned from the members how to tie different knots, like the square knot and the figure eight follow through knots. We headed back to the dorms feeling exhausted by night, but we enjoyed every minute of our fun-filled day.
Oh, to Holbert Island early in the morning on the seventh day. It was gorgeous. The water was completely smooth and it lightly washed against the pebbles where there was shells and sea glass to be found. We started our adventure by the day by splitting up into groups and doing three different service projects. Painting, picking up trash, and putting a sign up on the beach was our way of giving back to the land around us. Our day was super relaxed and it was nice to be able to hang out without a planned schedule. Your privacy, I don't believe in sanctity or hypocrisy. One of the highlights of the day was a lesson that Kate taught about four different leadership styles. We learned that the key to being an effective leader is to be able to adapt to whatever a situation requires. The day ended with a secret circle meeting that had the setting sun as the background. It was the perfect ending to the perfect day.
I got a little bit of hope, like a soap on a rope, sweeter than sour, getting thinner by the hour, falling fast, and I'm running out of gas, mugging on your sister, smart as Bobby Fischer, still I couldn't get arrested, though I got more hooks than Madonna got looks, just like that AC/DC song, come on baby, shake me all night long, all I wanna do is stay till early in.
Trip, we volunteered at a soup kitchen called Preble Street in Portland, Maine. Through three different locations, Preble Street serves hundreds of people three meals a day, every day of the year. We got to prepare bag lunches and hot meals, serve people food, and clean up afterwards. We were practicing the guiding principle of service, and everyone got something different out of the experience. Some a sense of purpose, others self-accomplishment. When we left, we all agreed that what we had done was extremely important. We help people meet needs that they were struggling to meet by themselves, and in that way we enable them to be more efficient in meeting their other, more attainable needs.
Hey everybody! Today, Rowing Academy went to the Gloucester Maritime Center, where we learned all about invasive species that have great effect on the environments they inhabit. We even got to collect samples of them and watch them move under our microscopes. We made a list together of how to prevent invasive species to enter our environments and the many ways they can enter habitats. Two staff at the center then gave us a tour of their awesome aquarium, which was filled with crabs, squid, multicolored lobsters, and other amazing sea life. And there was also a museum in store for us, which we got to take a look at, filled with boat models, antiques, and old footage of the sea craft from long ago. Once we said our goodbyes, we hopped back into Fran the van and resumed our journey.
They don't know where I've been for the past few years or so. Paris.